What is going on, guys? So, we are back with another hotel story time. And this one does not lack action. That's for goddamn sure. So, this past Saturday, I had to work. The day before our big New York trip. So, Saturday, I get to work. Everything seems normal. It all seems like your typical everyday Saturday morning, pretty slow. You know it's going to be a busy night, because Saturday is when a bunch of people check in for the weekend. So, Saturday, it's going good. Get to about 3:45. I get a call from housekeeping saying, hey, do you know what's going on with the guests in room 150? Are they a stayover or are they a checkout? Because it said that they're supposed to be checking out today. Housekeeper knocked on the door, didn't get a reply, put the key in, pushed the door open, the latch was on. So obviously somebody's inside, but no one said anything. It's like, all right, yeah, I'll go check it out. So I call my engineer, because engineer has a tool. So for those of you who think putting your little latch on means I can't get in your room, wrong. I can definitely get in your room. There's a little tool that slides, and once you open up the door, that little crack, you can slide this tool inside of there. It goes inside of the little groove that the latch goes on, that the little ball like kind of slides through the track on. It goes in there, you slam the door, and it pops the latch open. I can get in your room. So I brought him with me, because really at this point it was more of a wellness check, because she was supposed to check out at noon. It's now 4, and the housekeeper couldn't get in because the door was latched, and nobody made a sound whenever she tried to get in. So now it's more of checking on the well-being of the guest and making sure that everything's okay, somebody didn't pass out, or something crazy didn't happen. So at this point, I have no clue what I'm about to fucking walk into. So, we get to the door, knock, 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 front desk, knock, 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 front desk, no response. I'm like, all right. I'm like, all right, Brian, pop it open. So, puts his master key in, opens the door, latch, not on. So, I was like, all right. As soon as the latch hit, you hear, what the fuck are you doing? I was like, whoa, bitch. First of all, you ain't even supposed to be here. It's fucking 4:00. So I was like, ma'am, I'm here because one, your credit card is declining, which not even really her fault. We shouldn't have checked the bitch in with a declined credit card. That is one of the persistent issues I'm having with this new front desk team I'm trying to get right. But that's besides the point. I was like, ma'am, you're supposed to be checking out today, and you were supposed to be checking out 4 hours ago. I'm trying to figure out what's going on because we need you to leave this room because we are sold out tonight. I need to clean this room. Well, I don't need to clean it, but housekeeping needs to get in and clean this room. So she's like, no, I was never told what checkout time is. And I was like, ma'am, there's not a hotel in the world that checkout time's at 4. Not a hotel in the world. So I'm going to need you to get your things together, and it's time to go bye-bye, because you're not supposed to be in the room. It's time to leave. Also, I need a valid form of payment for this room, because currently, I have no dollars on this room. So that's a thing as well. She's like, I'll be out in 10 minutes. And I was like, all right, I will be waiting for you. And if you are not out in 10 minutes, I will be right back here knocking on your door. Needless to say, go to the desk. 10 minutes go by. I'm like this. I was like, oh, Sully, come on. My front office supervisor was like, come on with me, because I want as many witnesses to this as possible. Call Brian. Brian meets us there again. Knock, knock, knock. No answer. Knock, knock, knock. No answer. Brian, open the fucking door. Card in, card out. Right on the latch. And she starts yelling again. Why are you harassing me? And this is where I was done. I'm not playing your fucking game. It's 4:00. It's time to fucking leave the hotel. Bitch, get the fuck out. So I was like, ma'am, you had 10 minutes. I've seen no progress. You're still not answering the door when I knock. And for some reason, your latch is still on the room. It is time for you to go. You do not have a valid form of payment on the room. So I couldn't even extend the reservation and charge you for another night. And I obviously can't charge you for a late checkout. So it is time for you to leave now. And she goes, stop harassing me. I'll be out in 5 minutes. And I said, okay. And I'm going to stand right here with this door propped open until you come back. So let's go. Let's fucking get the hitch out of your giddy up and let's start moving, bitch. Because it's time to get your shit out of the room so I can have housekeeping clean it, since it's now 4 and they leave at 4:30. All right? How's that sound to you? So she starts the whole, you're harassing me. Oh my God, stop it. Leave me alone. This is ridiculous. Why are you here? And I said, ma'am, I am not leaving this door until you get your stuff and get out of the room. You do not have a valid form of payment on your reservation, and you were supposed to check out 4.5 hours ago. It is time to leave. I'm not playing your game. Meanwhile, my front office supervisor and the engineer are sitting there like, damn! I'm like, I'm done. Like, I'm not fucking with this bitch again. Like, this is not a game. I don't know why she thinks this is a joke, but it's fucking time to go. So she keeps yelling again, I'm not doing it, stop, leave me alone, I was never told, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, ma'am, you either stop talking, get your things together, or I'll just call the Woburn police and they can come and escort you out of the hotel. She's like, oh, are you threatening me? I said, ma'am, I'm not threatening you, I am telling you, this is what's going to happen, regardless of how you feel about it or not. So it's time for you to go. She started again. I was like, all right, that's fine. I said, Sully, call the police now. I'm done. I'm not doing this. This is insane. This bitch has lost her goddamn mind. So, calls the police. I send her to the end of the hallway so she can't try to come out and do something stupid or, like, try to run out. So, the cops were there in, like, I swear to God, maybe 3 minutes. It was actually quite incredible how quickly they got there. So, they walk up, got a short little guy, short little bald guy, you can tell, doesn't fucking play games, he knows how small he is, and he counteracts that with aggressiveness, and he doesn't take shit from anyone. That's what I got initially just from looking at the man, and later found out he was a Marine, so I guess I hit the nail on the head on that prediction. Second guy, bigger dude, probably about 6'2", about my height, but he's big, like he's rather stout. So, go to the door, they knock, knock, knock. I said, officer, she's not going to answer that. Brian, open the door. As soon as he opens the door, will you fucking leave me alone? I am doing what I need to do. Blah, 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 blah. And the cop goes, ma'am, this is Woburn Police. It's time to open the door. It's time to leave. She starts yelling again. And they're talking between the door. I said, guys, Brian, open the door. So Brian pops the door, and that's when she fucking flips. This bitch loses her shit. What the fuck are you doing in my room? Oh my God, why are you in here? Blah, 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 blah. Cop stands in the doorway, and he's like, ma'am, I'm not playing this game with you right now. It's time to get your stuff and go. This is insane. You were supposed to be gone at noon. Checkout time is not 4:30. To which she says, I am in the bathroom. I am naked. So the officer says, well, grab a towel because it's time to get your stuff together. I am not grabbing a towel. I am not grabbing a towel. And he said, well, what do you want to put on? I'll grab your clothes. No, I will grab my clothes. You need to get the fuck out of my room. And he said, no, it's not going to happen. It's not going to work like that. That's not what we're doing. So this dude proceeds to walk into the main part of the room, picks up a bag, like a grocery bag, full of shit, throws it into the bathroom as he's standing right in front of the door looking at her. And he goes, there you go, put your clothes on. She goes, that's not what I'm fucking wearing. She said, no, that's where you're wrong. That is what you're wearing. Put the fucking clothes on. And I'm like, oh, shit. It just got real. And then she starts yelling, you're harassing me, you're not allowed to do this, blah, 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 blah. He's like, ma'am, I am allowed to do this because you are currently defrauding an innkeeper by not giving a valid form of payment, and it's 4.5 hours out of your checkout time. You're not supposed to be here. And she responds, get out of my room. He said, ma'am, this isn't your fucking room. Get your shit and let's go. So she ends up like throwing on her clothes. She walks out of the room, keeps yapping her fucking mouth, won't shut the fuck up. This is ridiculous, you're harassing, blah, blah, blah. And she's like loud, cursing at the officers. And the officer, ma'am, you need to get your stuff together. It's time to go. Ma'am, you need to get your stuff together. And then he just goes, get your fucking shit and get the fuck out of the room now or I'm locking your ass up. To which she goes, fine, I'll get my stuff. He's like, you got 5 minutes. I'm done playing this game with you. I'm not wasting my time with you anymore. Sets a fucking timer on his watch. He's standing at the door. Meanwhile, the other cop happens to be the cop that showed up to my front office supervisor's car accident a few months back. He was the first person there, and they also happened to go to high school together. So they're chit-chatting. It's like this whole ordeal is not even going on because he's like, little guy can handle it. So keeps going on, and passes the five-minute mark. So the cop goes, ma'am, you've done nothing, and we're past the 5 minutes. That's when you saw another officer snap. He was done. This dude turns, busts into the room, pushes the door out of the way of the other guy. He says, ma'am, I'm fucking done with your shit. Let's go now. Starts picking up bags, walking over, throwing them in the hallway. This bitch is losing her goddamn mind. Freaking out. You can't do that. Drop my stuff. Oh my God. He's like, ma'am, shut the fuck up. This is happening or I'm locking you up and I'm throwing all this shit you have in the garbage. That's what will happen. Shut your mouth and let's go. She keeps going and going and going. Sully, meanwhile, goes and grabs a bell car because she has a metric fuck ton of stuff in her fucking room. So, comes back with a bell car. Officer's throwing it on the cart. She's still yelling. Get her out of the room. Finally, fucking an hour and a half later, she's out of the goddamn room. Officer's pushing the bell cart because I'm like, yo, we still need this fucking payment. That's great you got her out, but job's not done, sir. So, starts pushing the bell cart. She said, what are you doing? Get off of my fucking shit. And he goes, look, I'm just being a nice guy. She goes, no, you're not being a nice guy. You're being a fucking asshole. And I'm like, yo, I feel like you got maybe one more fucking asshole in you before he throws the cuffs on you. So you might want to go ahead, take it easy, cunt, because this is not going to work in your favor. So he goes, fine, let's go to the car. Starts rolling down the hallway. She comes up, grabs that shit, starts pushing like she's fucking running away. Then she heads, not to the front, she heads to the side exit. And I was like, ma'am, you can't go out that way. There's not a ramp for the cart. She says, stop following me. Stop harassing me. So when you go out the one door to the side entrance, you're in like this little foyer style setting. It's like door, space, another door. The bell cart's in there. We go in there and the officer goes, all right, ma'am, I need to see some ID. And she goes, I am not fucking talking to you. I'm not doing this. And he goes, you either show me ID or I'm going to start going through your bags. And I'm like, yo, little guy does not play games. So she goes, leave me alone. So this bitch fucking squats down, starts unzipping her bag. She flips out again, grabs a wallet out of a bag, and has no form of identification in it. So then she's like pulling out documents and he's like, ma'am, I asked for an ID. And she goes, I'm giving you one. She pulls out like a lease or something. I don't fucking know. So this is when it gets real good. I laughed out loud with the bitch right there when this happened. They see the ID, whatever, blah, 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 blah. Then they tell her, and if you don't pay, like, do you have the money to pay this? She goes, of course I don't. The guy last night said it was free. Bullshit. Did not happen. Let's be real. Yeah, guy said it's free. Okay. So he's like, all right, well, I'm going to summon you to court. Are you fucking joking? No, ma'am. Picks up his phone, pushes a few buttons. He's like, I actually just did it. You'll get a notice in the mail. And if you don't show up for this court date to settle your debt, we will put a warrant out for your arrest. She's like, oh my God, really? For what? And he said, defrauding an innkeeper. She's like, what the fuck does that even mean? His response, I didn't think you'd understand. I'm like, yo, this is too fucking priceless right now. So then this is where I laughed out loud. She picks up two bags off the cart. She goes out the front door. And she goes out that side door, the exit. And she proceeds to drop the bags. The door closes behind her. She turns around. Obviously, the side entrance to the hotel is locked. You need a guest room key. She grabs the door to get in. And it's locked. The officers even chuckled. She starts screaming, open the fucking door! Oh, so while that happens, while the other guy opens the door, the other officer, little guy, he's calling it in to see if there's any outstanding warrants or anything on this lady. You hear him call back and say, looks like everything's clean. She's got a couple priors, but she has a suspended license. He goes, okay, I'll keep that in mind. This bitch eventually gets all her stuff out. We shut the door. It's over. She's getting summons to court, blah, blah, blah. And I said, she had a suspended license. He goes, yeah. So I'm going to go out front. I'm going to watch for her to get into a car. And as soon as she turns it on, we're going to take her to jail anyway. No stop sign there. So that's literally what they did. They go out front. Cruiser's sitting there. You see this bitch come out with all this shit from like 4 trips to a car. And then she gets in the car, and I'm like, oh shit, you see the car start creeping? This bitch, you see the lights turn on, you see the taillights turn on, and then you see the two officers fly over, just cut her off, get her out of the car, throw her in cuffs, put her in the back, and then they just drive away. End of story. Oh man. Yeah, so I then got a fucking no trespassing letter and sent it to the address the officer gave me for her. So he was like, yeah, she ever comes back, give me a call, here's my number, we'll come lock her ass up on the spot. Oh man, couldn't just be a normal Saturday. Could not be a normal Saturday. But it made for one hell of a hotel story time. So hey, look guys, no sex this time. Isn't that awesome? No sex involved in the story. So we switched it up a little bit. So I hope you guys enjoyed this this latest edition of Hotel Storytime. I know at the time, the beginning, I wasn't enjoying it because I was getting really pissed at this bitch because she was just this fucking stupid hoe. But then when the cops came, that's when shit got interesting because it was no longer my problem. I was just getting to watch the shit show unveil. But yeah, it was quite a good time. So let me know what you think about this video in the comments section. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to give me a like and a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, because these stories come out a lot. I see a lot of fucked up shit. But have a great day, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And as always, let me get through this bump first. Hey!